Most late model vehicles, well, they're going to have ABS at least, probably stability control, and on some, you're going to see an ADAS system. This makes alignment even more crucial to the function of the vehicle. So Dave, with the alignments on a vehicle, what does a technician need to be aware of when they're making adjustments and also the tolerances?
Well, it's just no more set the toe and let it go kind of thing, Andrew. Camber, caster, toe has tighter tolerances on ADAS equipped vehicles than on non-ADAS equipped vehicles these days.
What about vehicles that are coming out of the factory that are net builds that don't have any adjustment? Should we just assume that they're okay?
If they are non-adjustable from the factory, we need to figure out if they can be made adjustable to restore them back to proper alignment angles. A lot of times, if that's not available, correction of ride height usually takes care of that.
The measurement process, has that changed in probably the last 15, 20 years?
We're using digital imaging now is what we use. We have a three-dimensional target on the wheel itself, and we can see the movements of the wheel as the adjustments are being done.
Let's talk about this vehicle right here. It actually has eccentric bolts to adjust the camber.
Right.
Toe can be adjusted.
Right.
Camber can't be adjusted. In the back, well, we've got a trailing arm axle.
Right.
That one, it's shim, so it's a little bit more labor intensive.
It is, but it still can be corrected.
So when should a technician be concerned looking at some of the alignment angles when he should maybe flag something and maybe investigate other issues with the vehicle, let's say a bent control arm or worn out bushings?
Well, right here, you're pretty much looking at the primary alignment angles. You're looking camber, caster, and toe in the front, camber, toe in the rear, and thrust angle on the rear also. Now, if I can get these within specifications, a lot of the secondary alignment angles fall into place also. But say I got excessive camber, excessive caster, and say it's non-adjustable or I've maxed out my adjustment. Well, what do I do now? Well, that's when we start making additional measurements, steering axis inclination, included angle, setback. These kind of angles tell me where the particular wheel is on that particular corner of the vehicle. Toe is the most critical tire wear angle that there is. Okay, it's going to have a very tight tolerance. Typically, usually about a tenth of a degree for total toe. That's both wheels, both sides put together there. And that's a very tight tolerance to maintain. It doesn't take very little movement of the tie rod in or adjuster sleeve to get that amount of change out of it. Way we do it is using a process known as a wind toe.
Let's walk through that process.
So what I'm going to do here, the steering wheel icon here is wind toe itself. The first thing I'm going to do is start the engine level of the steering wheel.
Okay.
So we did that already. I'm going to press the ready key here. Now, this particular one here, you can see the arrows on the outside of this. It's at negative 26 one-hundredths of a degree. That's not telling me the actual toe angle. That's telling me how far away from specification that I am. Okay. It says adjust the right tie rod towards zero, jounce the vehicle. Very, very important. Equalize or flatten out the tie rod end, and then lock down the tie rod jam nut itself.
Almost there. Okay.
And tighten it down.
Got
and
it.
Good.
Okay.
Okay. So I completed step two, so I'm going to go ahead and go to step three now. Now we're going to do exactly the same thing on the other side. Now this one's on the positive side or the inside of the bar graph itself. So I'm towing in, so I need to tow this wheel out from specification here.
Shorten.
So we're going to do that on this particular one here. I'm going to tow the wheel out, get it close to. Tighten the jam nut down now.
Okay.
And good. All right. So we're going to press the ready key. We jounced it again. Press the ready key here. Step four is going to have us check the position of the steering wheel now. What this does is what we call a steer ahead screen or bar graph, and this is going to equalize front individual toe. Okay. For a vehicle to go in a straight path, front individual toe needs to be equal. Okay, so we'll adjust it left and right here and get it back to the center and right about there, and we'll press the ready button here, and you can see that this is what we actually adjusted toe to, and they're both equal. So the steering wheel is currently in a straight position, so that's where the steering wheel should be when it goes down a straight road.
Well, thanks, Dave, for that analysis on toe and making this job just a little bit easier.
All right, you're welcome.